Today is glazing day. Today I'm going to show you how I turn a bisque bowl into a bluegrass bowl, how I'll take a teapot and make it mountain mist, and my prairies glaze, how I apply the prairies to a batter bowl and everything else to get the brown. But before you can apply any glazes, you have to make sure your pots are washed and waxed and ready to go. By washed, I mean you don't run it through the dishwasher. I just have a bucket of water here, and I run a damp sponge inside and out. And I like to make sure there's no dust on the pot. Because if you leave dust on your pot, what'll happen is your glaze will stick to the dust and not to the pot, and you will have issues. I'm just going to wipe this off and get it, make sure it's clean. You can see by the wash water, I've washed all these pots, and there's a lot of dust on these pots. So now I'm washed and waxed. I like to use this big waxing tray. Just about everything fits in it, and I like to use paraffin because melted paraffin gives a nice straight wax line and it goes very quickly. So now it's washed, waxed, and wetty. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to glaze a lot of this stuff when you're not looking, because you're not going to watch me glaze for all day. And then you'll come back when I've got it ready to decorate and to put the different colors on, how I apply the light and the dark to the different glazes, and I'll show you how I apply my mountain mist and my prairies and how I make the run on the bluegrass. But right now I'm going to get to work, and I'll see you on the other side. Okay, here we are back on the other side. This side looks much like the side we left before, but this side is much messier, and I've got all my glazing done. So I just want to tell you a little bit about the glazes I use. This glaze is Mountain Mist. It has all the colors of the Alberta Mountains, and it is, the colors are splashed around. I'll show you how in just a minute. My other glaze here is called Bluegrass, and it is has nothing to do with the Alberta Mountains. And we have prairies, and it has all the colors of the Alberta prairies, the white, the blues, the golds. And so I'm going to put the glaze on this one. The thing is, I'm going to talk about my glazes are kind of interesting, is they all basically the same glaze. This, the blue and the brown are the same base of the same glaze. This brown here is the same gold that makes there, but when I apply it to the bluegrass, the gold goes to blue, and it's the same that makes the inside of the mountain mist. Anyway, it's kind of like when your closet, when you've got like three pairs of pants and three tops, they're all different colors. You mix them all up, looks like you have a lot of clothes. They're all basically the same glaze slopped around differently. Okay, so I'm going to stir it up. Now, I like to use a big bucket of glaze. I don't like fiddle farting around with a little bucket of glaze. And I want to use a large... It's just like that waxing thing I wax, and everything goes in the big bucket. So, now I'll tell you quickly about my hydrometer. I like to make sure my glazes have the same thickness, consistency throughout. I have a beer hydrometer, but it's the glaze is much thicker. So what I did is I just got the glaze the consistency where I want, and then I drop it in, and it goes to the line for that glaze. There's an old joke, kind of like, if you can't color inside the lines, color what you like and draw a line around it. My hydrometer is the same way. Okay, so I've got my glaze mixed up. I'll give it one more mix because I was yapping. And I also like to use big dipping tongs. Big dipping tongs to dip big things. So this glaze, I'm going to show you how I paint the mountains on, but this just shows you the advantages of using a big bucket of glaze, because everything fits. Just give it a tip, flop it down, and it goes in. And I would glaze, I'll get to this bowl over here in a minute, but I'm going to show you how I glaze the mountain mist first. I pour the glaze in and then pour the glaze out. We'll do that. Pour the glaze in, pour the glaze out, then dip the rim. and I stir a lot. Glaze likes to settle. So I thought I'd glaze the big bowls because I've got a video in the links below, have a look, on how to throw a large bowl. I also have some shorts up there about throwing bowls, and I thought if you watch the video on how to throw, you might want to watch how to glaze. So I'm just going to pour it up. Now when I throw a bowl, I throw a big rim on the bottom. One, it makes it look nice, and two, you've got a handle when you dip it in. And I like these big buckets of glaze because everybody fits. Okay, so I'm going to let that dry. I'll show you in a minute how I splash the mountains on, but I'll put it on a different bowl because that one's wet. While I got the glaze stirred up, let's glaze the other bowl. So that bowl is a pour in, pour out, dip the glaze. And this one, with the same Rio Ox red glaze that does the gold, is going to, when I dip it in there, do the blue. And give it a stir. And I like these big dipping tongs. Many years ago, we lived in Edmonton, and we knew a guy who made these, and I don't know where he is anymore. If anybody knows where to find big dipping tongs, please leave me a message in the comments below, because I wouldn't mind having more than one pair. So then you just basically dip it. So that's the bluegrass with the red iron oxide glaze on the top, dipped in the same base as the mountain mist. So now those are still too wet to splash, but I'm going to get Jim just to stop for a minute, and I'm going to show you how I splash, but I have to get it set up. When I was glazing, I forgot to glaze a mug. The mug is the only one of this glaze and the prairies that has an actual splash pattern. The other ones, which are for the mountains, the other ones you splash on the outside, you kind of get what you get. So I wanted to show you how to do it. I did the mug and pour it in.
License.
You pour it out, and then dip the rim.
Yeah.
And I dip the handle, so it's no one, I don't like the feeling of raw clay. So then there's that. Now I said that I was not going to put the mountains on this one because it needed time to dry. It took me a long time to get organized. It's dry. But I'm not going to do all the splashing. So I just, the mountains are just that. I just splash like little triangles with the glaze. And this is just a personal cleansing bottle to clean all those little places. But it's my paintbrush. So I would let that dry, and the mountains would be the same. I could do three mountains, but you can do two. There's no rules, it's landscape. So then we're gonna do the mountains. And then when it's dry, I would splash black around the bottom, and I would use the same Rio that I use in everything else at the bottom. And they do come out pretty. They look like little mountain scenes. This one has, I said, can I do that? No. This one I like to splash. Whoa. Just see if you're watching. This one I like to splash this way. And then what I would do is I would splash the black opposite. The black would go, so that one goes that way, the black goes that way. Then I turn it over and run it, and so it gets this just really sort of cool running down the front. And you can see, oh, I don't have a mug here, but you can see it in the prairie mug, how it all kind of blends together like that. Anyway, so that is glazing. Okay, this is the result of the glazing I did earlier in the video. This is the bowl I painted the mountains on, and then I splashed the black and the brown. I dipped this big bowl to make the bluegrass, and I painted mountains, I think, on that tray. Anyway, so these are the bowls, the trays, and everything that came out. And the bowls are kind of fun because they go... If you have any questions, I would love to hear from you in the comments below. If you have any comments, you can put them in the comments below. If you like this, people always say, if you like this, smash the like button. This is the studio,
Don't like the root smash? If you like it, click the like button. And if you want to hear more about me and how I make my pots, please subscribe. And thank you ever so much for watching.